and they call themselves the guardians of the secrets of the ages. And their first religion was called astrotheology, or the worship of the heavens. And their first object of worship was the sun. The second object of worship was the moon. And everywhere you see the mystery schools or the mystery religion, you will see the symbols of the sun and the moon, also known as Osiris and Isis, and the child Horus, which I will explain the meaning of later. Right now, folks, we must take a break. Don't go away. I'll be right back after this very short pause. Intellect set him upon a quest that, according to those who say that they know, has never ended, even unto this day. And the modern day equivalent of this ancient mystery religion calls itself the Order of the Quest. And you will see it reflected in many of their outward exoteric branches, where they disseminate information to the public, or manipulate the public, or deceive the public, as the profane to them are nothing more than cattle to be herded and occasionally to be led to the slaughter. In the movie 2001, the quest led them ultimately into space and to the moon, where they were further imparted knowledge by Lucifer, again, in the form of the obelisk, the monolith, the stone, the penis. And you will understand what that means later when we get into the Osirian cycle, or the legend of Isis, Osiris, and the child Horus. When they were imparted knowledge again on the moon, it set them off on a further quest to the planet Jupiter, where they found a huge, tremendous, again, another obelisk, monolith, stone, the generative force, the penis, floating in space, orbiting the planet Jupiter. Now, the journey from the moon to Jupiter is significant, for the astronauts on board this spaceship represented the entirety of the human race. And it represented that some will evolve, and those who cannot will not be allowed into the future. You see, this was a message from those who rule to all of the initiates of the world. It was a message that the new age is now dawning. And you see that at one point during this journey from the moon to Jupiter, man represented on a microcosm by the astronauts making this voyage came in conflict with their own technology. The technology of the human race was represented by the computer called HAL. And for those who were intelligent enough to experiment with the name HAL and progressed the letters one forward in the alphabet from what they were in the movie, H became I, A became B, and L became M, and they were able to see that the symbol was of the largest at that time when the movie was made. And the corporation that was on the cutting edge of computer technology, IBM. It was significant that man had built this technology, this computer, which had an artificial intelligence and was capable of communicating with the astronauts. And yet they had forgotten to put a switch in the machine which could be turned off at will. Now, you have to understand that this is all symbology. HAL represented many things. He represented the atomic bomb, the hydrogen bomb, chemical warfare, bacteriological warfare, represented the state of the art of technology, where it became so complicated that no one man could be an expert in it, and thus might unknowingly participate in the building of a technology which could destroy him. Yet he only worked on a part or a portion of it, the knowledge of which did not indicate to him that the end product could be a danger. And we see that happening now, don't we? where everybody has to specialize in one small portion of technology because the overall picture is so complicated and so far beyond.